I'm Jim Phillips. I want to welcome you to what we hope is the first of a series of video presentations dealing with lost and found treasures in Alabama. I'm a historian. I'm a video producer. Did a lot of corporate videos. But years ago, a fellow I knew I loved history. And they hired me to do the history of this county and then hired to do the history of that county in Alabama. I did a video of the history of Tannehill Confederate Furnace. I did a video of the history of a couple of colleges. I did a video of dealing with old aviation in Alabama. But I started metal detecting back about 1991. One of my history videos was a rural county, and I came across all these magnificent antebellum mansions and met the owners. And man, they laid the welcome mat out. And I always wanted to do that. So I got a metal detector, I got out, and I started finding things. Now let me tell you though, I always like to add this. Bought my first metal detector. The guy is a great treasure hunter. He's nationally famous. I bought a metal detector from him. He says, now, do you expect to buy this and go right out and find gold and buried treasure and everything? I said, no, I expect to buy this and go out and find pull tabs and trash for a good 6 months and maybe find a wheat penny starting out. He said, you've already found your treasure. It's the solitude, the beauty of nature, the exercise out there hunting. This is what I want to stress for people who want to start metal detecting. I think a lot of people get spoiled in this day of iPads and social media. Everything's fast-paced. You want to go out and be able to explore, enjoy nature, and maybe even do it by yourself, but not far off where you could get in trouble and nobody knows where you are. But he told me when I said, that's what I want to do, get out there and find solitude and peace and occasionally find something. And he said, you've already found your treasure. Always remember that. And you will, once you learn to do this, start finding some valuable things. Now, I'm a historian. I did videos of these counties. People were fascinated with it. I started exploring more places in Alabama. When I was in undergraduate school at the University of Alabama, I used to travel the old rivers looking for the ghost towns. I was fascinated with it. So people started hiring me to come talk at social clubs back about 12 years ago, speak to senior clubs at churches that have spawned now to where I talk at retirement villages, libraries, universities, and social clubs, even senior centers. My forte, my strength is in lost antebellum Alabama. I talk about the old ghost towns. I talk about traveling on steamboats, steamboat ghost towns, the danger of traveling on steamboats, what first class and second class passes was like. I talk about the forgotten stagecoach routes, what it was like to stop in the taverns, what they call the old ordinaries on the old stagecoach pass. Fascinating, the things that went on. Now, all this plays into lost treasures. Buried coins, some buried as caches intentionally. Some found, some not found. Drop coins, drop jewelry. I really get into this stuff. And some years ago, I got into hunting old bottles because you come across old dumps and I met bottle diggers. And man, is that fun. I tell people in my younger days, I used to dream at night and more or less dream about a 30-year-old Marilyn Monroe, for those who know you are, who she is, riding with me in my old MGB convertible heading to the beach. And then I started metal detecting. I dreamed about Marilyn Monroe riding with me, my metal detector in the back, and my shovel. Then I got into bottle digging. I started dreaming about my metal detector in the front seat where Marilyn used to be, and my shovel and bottle digging tools in the back seat. So there's a new passion in life. You really get obsessed with this sort of thing. But I want to, in future episodes, I'm going to talk about one of the legendary treasure tales in Alabama. There are several of them. There's the missing gold cross on Dolphin Island that was supposedly thrown down a well. It was on top of a church, and they threw it down a well when the pirates attacked. That's not what I heard from a priest down there when I lived on the island in 1972. French priest goes back to France and researches this. I never heard of the cross. He tells me where it is. It was intended for Governor Cadillac's altar, and it never made it. He tells me where it is on the island, and he gave me all the evidence, and I believe that. But you better have about $5 million if you're going to go for it. There's story after story. The antebellum infant's gold ring. The valuable Hutchinson bottles from Alabama that are legendary. You want to know about these. I'm going to talk about how to research, how to find, how to do it safely, how to market and document the history of your objects. So this is an intro to what I'm going to be doing. And we're going to narrow different presentations to cover different categories. So I want you to check back in on me so I can teach you how to have a lot of fun, enhance your historical education, and make a profit doing it. Thanks a lot.